People often think pupil referral units are nothing more than a breeding ground for gangs. Recently, they've had a lot of bad press, but these perceptions can often be wrong.
I spent years working with vulnerable young people, and I understand the importance of them having a safe and stable place to learn. Being at the PRU gives them the opportunity to do this, combined with teachers that care and understand and really want them to succeed.
What are some of the things that you feel you may have been labelled with, or some of your friends may have been labelled with? Bad attitude.
Stupid,
yeah.
This is the pavilion in Barnet. All the kids here have been excluded from mainstream school. Talia is an ex-pupil here. She's back today teaching a class, trying to show them how they can turn their lives around.
What got you into the PRU?
I had a lot going on at home, which was causing disruptions in my behaviour at school, and I very quickly got labelled and branded as a disruptive child.
Tell me a bit about your journey from attending the PRU to where you are now.
So I run a youth organisation called Youth Realities, and we work with teenagers to address teenage relationship abuse. Going to a PRU and having this added experience means that young people can relate with me a bit more than maybe somebody who didn't have that experience.
A lot of the students here have really complex needs, which meant they just couldn't cope in mainstream school.
What got you into the PRU? Saffron?
Fighting.
And I just didn't get on there.
Just behaviour problems, and so on. I got into a fight, and then just I failed all my management after that.
What did you think they were like before you came here?
Anger problems, a lot of fighting. I was thinking to myself, I might have to fight someone, but nah, not the case.
Here, the timetables are designed around each child, and classes don't have to be academic.
What sort of support do you get here that you weren't getting when you were at mainstream school?
It's more like one-to-one, and you get to actually like talk to teachers.
What sort of sports do you do here?
Boxing. Through the whole week, people like build up like a lot of anger, and then, like, people can release it when you do boxing and that.
Well, how did you feel when school said you're not allowed to come back here?
It was just unsettling, to be fair.
So now you're here, do you feel settled?
Yeah, I do.
Like, made me kind of like cool down, simmer down a bit. So yeah, kind of made me, like, in a way, made me feel like a better person.
It's not always easy here. Serious behaviour problems are the norm and violence can break out. But it's a challenge that these teachers are willing to take on.
We learn about de-escalation techniques. We do learn restraint, although we very, very rarely use it. The one thing that we all have in common is that we are absolutely passionate about young people with SEMH, or social emotional mental health difficulties, and we all believe that every young person deserves a second chance.
PRUs sometimes have a bad reputation. How does this affect you as a school?
It's frustrating. And we work very, very hard to make sure that the negative perception within the media of pupil referral units or AP doesn't affect what we do.
The pavilion works with other organisations and charities to give the kids extra support, from therapy to practical life skills. Rachel is a deputy head and believes that giving them more experiences is really important.
One of the things that I put in place when I started here is an annual trip to Mount Snowdon in Wales. It's a way of showing our students that we trust them. These are young people where, when they were in mainstream school, they weren't allowed on trips. One of the trips that we did, I was stood at the summit and on the summit, and I saw one of my young people stood away from everybody else actually and was just kind of looking. But he just turned and looked at me and said, "This is amazing. I don't need the ends. This is amazing. Look at this. This is lifeless, isn't it? This is real."
When they first arrive here, a lot of the kids are on the verge of going down a path that could really ruin their lives.
Sorry.
Being in this environment and the support that they get here can give them another chance. Katie Orchard, ITV News.